Thank you for joining us today for our fall concert, Vox Femina, celebrating women in choral music. My name is Chris Markle, and I'm one of the conductors of your choir. I'm also just a little taller. From Hildegard in the 12th century through to the present day, women have made a significant contribution to choral music, which has often been overlooked. Many times, choral directors may select those pieces of which their audiences may be more familiar. In most cases, these selections have been composed by men. When we demonstrate to our strong-minded and passionate young women that their work is valued in all aspects of our world, the spark of their creativity can be grown into a flame which will burn for their entire lives and warm the hearts of men. I believe that good choral literature should be performed because it is good choral literature. I also believe that it is equally important for choral directors to inform their female choristers and their audiences that a world of choral music has existed for more than 850 years that has included women as poets, lyricists, composers, and arrangers. Today's performance features the arts of 11 women and spanning over 850 years. Eight of these women are still alive today. Our first selection, Jubilate Deo, is taken from the text of Psalm 100 of the Bible. It is written by Emily Crocker, the founder of the Milwaukee Children's Choir. Still residing in Milwaukee, Ms. Crocker's work has been performed around the world. Specializing in choral literature for children's ensembles, she now works as vice president of choral publications for Hal Leonard. With research in contemporary modal music, our next composer, Carlotta Ferrari, is a music educator at the European School of Economics in Florence, Italy. She is currently studying the intersection of art and science. With this interest, it is very appropriate that her music is set to the text of Hildegard von Bingen. It is impossible to summarize the work of Hildegard in just a few moments. She was a musician, author, poet, scientist, and Christian mystic. Perhaps no other medieval composer has captivated the interests of popular audiences, scholars, and religious faithful as Hildegard von Bingen. Because of her isolation at a convent in the hills of Germany, more work can definitely be attributed to Hildegard than any other composer from the Middle Ages. And now, O Frondens Bjørg.
Thank you.
Italian composer and arranger Angelina Figes has been using contemporary arranging styles to add her personal flair to familiar choral works. This Catholic prayer is comprised of a greeting proclaimed to Mary at the Annunciation by the Archangel Gabriel in the Book of Luke. The text is supplemented by Elizabeth's greeting to her cousin Mary, along with words adapted by the Council of Trent. This is Ave Maria. Song of Solomon is a series of lyrical poems organized in the Bible as a lengthy dialogue between a young woman and her lover. Early Hebrew and Christian scholars long maintained that the love story is an allegory of God's love for humankind. However, it is undeniable that the song celebrates not only human love, but also the mystical quality of desire. Here is Arise, Beloved.
Oh,
Susan Lavar has been active as a singer, pianist, and composer much of her life. She studied composition at Missouri State University. Her works are in demand for honor choirs and festivals all across the United States. The Book of Ruth includes the key characters Ruth, Naomi, and Boaz. In addition to establishing an important genealogy in the Bible, the Book of Ruth demonstrates the kind of love, loyalty, and faithfulness that God desires for us. This is my very own.
My love, my love.
Swedish poet May Swenson's poetry was widely praised for its precise and beguiling imagery and for the quality of its personal and imaginative observations. The literary journal Women's Review of Books commented that Swenson was a visionary poet, a prodigious observer of the fragile and miraculous natural world. Performed throughout the country, the music of American poet Gwyneth Walker is beloved by performers and audiences alike for its energy, beauty, reverence, drama, and humor. Walker is a graduate of Brown University and the Hart School of Music. A former faculty member at Oberlin College Conservatory, she resigned from academic employment in 1982 in order to pursue a career as a full-time composer. For nearly 30 years, she has lived on a dairy farm in Braintree, Vermont. She now divides her time between her childhood hometown of New Canaan, Connecticut, and the musical community of Randolph, Vermont. Featuring the women of Rivercord, here is I Will Be There. point, we'll take a brief intermission, and we will begin again shortly. Thank you again for coming.
Thank you. Sigh no more, lady, sigh no more, sigh no more, no more. Man would you see those heaven? One couldn't see, one couldn't see, one couldn't see, and one ashore, and one ashore to go in constant heaven. But let it go, let be in light and glory, converting your sounds of woe into. Sing no more, ditty, sing no more, sing no more, no more. A dog so dull and heavy, fraud of men, a fraud of men, a fraud of men, was ever so, since summer first was heavy. But let it go, and be light and holy, converting your sounds of woe into.
We want to take a moment to share with you our upcoming events in the community. On Sunday, December 1st, we will present a sing-along of George Friedrich Handel's Messiah. We encourage you to come out and join us. We will provide the scores for those who don't have them. Why wouldn't we have them? This concert will be here at the time. On Sunday, Saturday, December 14th, at 7:30, we will join the Clinton Symphony Orchestra for Holiday with the Symphony at Clinton High School in the auditorium. This will be a great event to help get you in the holiday spirit if the snow has already done it for you. Each concert series cannot happen without the hard work and dedication from some select individuals who I would like to acknowledge. We'd like to extend our positive thoughts and prayers for recovery to my co-conductor, Carl Wolf, who had his hip replaced in October. I know that while this was not the timeline he wanted, he will be better for it on the other side. Of recovery, it's not dying. We look forward to having him back soon. Our ensemble manager, Brooke Logan, has done an amazing job of keeping number 4 organized for many years. She keeps our website updated, initiates our public relations, and provides communication for all our members. Please help me thank Brooke for her years. For that, we are ever grateful. Please help me thank Chris for sharing.